World War II. It's estimated Nazi Germany steals as much as the modern equivalent of $5.5 billion worth of gold from foreign governments.
It's what the victors did to the vanquished throughout human history. It just shows an extreme form of a fascination with gold, that we have to grab all the gold we can.
The Nazis store their gold plunder in the Reich Bank in Berlin. In the dying days of the war, with Allied bombers pounding the city, the Nazis move it to a safer place. General Patton's advancing army receives a report that some of it is hidden in a salt mine in central Germany. In April 1945, Patton and Supreme Commander Dwight Eisenhower go down into the mine to see for themselves. Two of the highest-ranking men in the U.S. Army. A worn-out cable holds them from a 2,100-foot freefall to the bottom. They have no idea what awaits. There before them, an unbelievable sight. More than 4,000 sacks, all neatly cataloged and stuffed with gold bullion. 100 tons of it. Evidence of the largest robbery in the history of the world. There's a vast quantity of personal items of gold, mainly stolen from Jews before they were sent off to their death. Man's greed knows no bounds.
They took gold out of teeth of people that they murdered. They stole a lot of gold. They pretty much stole everything they could get their hands on.
The gold is hauled up by U.S. Army engineers and shipped to a bank vault in Frankfurt. Perhaps some of it is the gold Peter Monk's